Hi everyone, it's Kim. This is K Ray Creations. Thanks. Oh, look at the painting. I even washed my hands already. Anyway, I just kind of wanted to make a video for you guys. I did a pour for my mom, and then embellished with painting the wine glass. And this one is actually for my daughter-in-law, and she prefers red wine, but she really wanted one. Instead of the black background, I went ahead and did kind of a silvery gray base. It has a little shimmer to it because it was actually from a bunch of scraped pores, and it turned into this really pretty gray, so I thought I'd use that. I did the red embellishment. So I'm not gonna talk through this whole thing because it's kind of a long process sometimes. But what I will do is fast forward, but I wanted to show you how I start and explain it a little bit. I'm sorry, I'm just looking for a different paintbrush that I wanted. What I've done is went ahead and outlined the shape of my wine glass in just white chalk, just to give me an idea of where I want it to go, how I want it placed, and then I'm gonna go back and paint and highlight. I did cut out a reference of a wine glass from the internet. I just went on and found one the shape I kind of wanted. I sized it kind of how I needed it. But you can see where the lip is the same size. It was a little too big down here. So while I kind of gave myself a reference, my bottom part I made a little bit slimmer, if you can see. It doesn't look super even right now only because the chalk line isn't even. Oh, does it? I don't even know. Does that look? Now that I'm looking at this through the camera, this looks like it can come in just a tad bit more. I'm thinking. So to kind of give myself the angle that I want, I know that I did it like this. And yeah, sometimes I do just freehand stuff. Sometimes I do use something I found online. I think that's a little bit better. Yeah, okay. As a reference, and you know, you can go back and mess with it. So what I typically do is once I have my chalk line, I'm gonna go on the inside of that chalk line with my tiny little paintbrush and a little bit of black. This black is mixed a little bit with a little bit of water. If you have some already mixed, you can use that too. Whatever you have. I just find if you have, I'm gonna need a little bit more water with that. Have it with a little, thinned out just a tad. It's just easier to manipulate, obviously, than the thick paint. I'm not even sure what black this is. Doesn't matter because it's just gonna give me my outline at this point. I'm gonna be going back in and darkening spots and highlighting spots. So if it's just a very thin black line, that's okay. And before I stop talking and turn on fast forward mode for you, you do want to make sure that your paintings are pretty much fully cured. Only because, you know, I make mistakes and redo all the time when I'm embellishing. And I'll use a little alcohol wipe. And if your paint underneath is not cured, you're gonna wipe that off right along with the paint that you're putting on top. That makes sense. So you really kind of want to make sure that it is fully cured. The other thing you can do, because I'm not sure that this one is for the fully cured, actually. Like I said, it's for a birthday present, and I want to get it done. But so then what you can also do is before you start your embellishment is just go ahead and give it a light spray varnish, like a really thin layer of a varnish to set that. You know, a lot of people say, you know, you're still might run the risk of doing it too soon, but you're not running the risk with the spray varnish, a light spray varnish coat, as you would be if you're using like resin or the Liquitec varnish and you're finishing your painting that way. That's when you're really sealing in that moisture, and if there's moisture left in your paints, and you run the risk of ruining your painting. So anyway, saying with that being said, I'm just gonna go ahead and finish my outline and fast forward, and I hope you guys enjoy. If you have any questions, or you know, please feel free to comment and like and subscribe and all that good stuff. And take care, you guys, and keep pouring for your soul.